Okay students, so now let us go for our first theorem. Clear? So in exam, the statement of the theorem will be given. Are you getting my point? The statement of the theorem will be given like this. Or they can just give, derive the equation of line in space passing through the given point and parallel to the given vector, both in Cartesian form and vector form. That is what given here. Clear? See, derive the equation of the line in space passing through a point and parallel to a given vector b, both in vector and Cartesian form. This explanation can be also given, or they will give derive the vector of line, sorry, derive the equation of line passing through a given point and parallel to a given vector in both vector and Cartesian form, or they may give just like that. Are you getting my point? But the statement will be given like this, either in the explanation form or in the short form, as derive the equation of line in space passing through a given point and parallel to a given vector, both in vector form and Cartesian form. Please remember, like this they will ask in both forms, not only a single form, vector form and Cartesian form they will ask, not only in a single form. Clear? Okay. So now, as you all know how to represent a point in space, clear? Because here what they have given, derive the equation of line in space passing through a given point. That's why I have explained that much in your previous class of your basics of three-dimensional geometry theorems. Because if you know that basics, just you can go on solving here. Clear? Before you know that basics, you can't do anything. So please watch that video which I have explained all the basics of representation of a point, a line and everything which is need for your theorems. So if you watch that, these things are going to be very simple. If you don't watch, these things are not going to be very simple. Clear? To make this as simple, please must watch the previous video, that where I have explained what are going to be the important terms for your theorems. Clear? Okay. Because you can observe here, derive the equation of line in space passing through a point. That means first you must know the point in space and the representation of point in space. Are you clear? And parallel to a given vector b. That means there is one vector b. Clear? As we all studied vector AP in previous class. Vector AP given as vector OP minus vector OA. Clear? Like that, in the place of AP, here we have vector AB. Are you getting my point? So vector B is given, no problem. Given things, no problem. Are you getting my point? What we have to find? That we have to concentrate. Clear? Okay. We have to find both in vector and Cartesian form. We have to find both in vector and Cartesian form. Okay students, so see here. First what I will do, I will draw my space of x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. I will draw my space, clear? And what I will draw? I will draw a point, because point A is given. See here, passing through a point, that means point is given. Next, if the point, we draw point in space, we should represent it. How we should represent? With vector OA. That we should represent. Okay. So now line is passing through this. See, let us draw a line passing through a point. Clear? So this is point A. Now line is passing through a point A, and vector OA is the representation of point A. Next, and parallel to a given vector B, that is nothing but this is the parallel vector B. Clear? Line is passing through a given point and it is parallel to a vector B. Okay. So now what we shall do? They have given a point A. That means there is given point. No problem. For solving this, we must consider one arbitrary point. Are you getting my terms? First, we must draw a given point Next, we must choose one arbitrary point. Let us choose one arbitrary point P. Let us choose some arbitrary point P. Join O to P. Clear, students? Join O to P. So, as you all know, how to write vector OA? If you don't know, you see my previous video. There I have written the position vector of OA as vector A. Vector OA as vector OA must be written as vector A. Next, vector OP must be written as vector R. That is, vector OP equal to vector R. Are you getting my point? Vector A is position vector of point A. Vector R is position vector of point B. Clear? Vector B is given vector. Clear? So now, I will join A to P. That means, you must find vector AP. You must find vector AP. So, as you all know, what is the formula for vector AP? If you don't remember, you go for your previous class. That is, vector AP, which ends with P, we should start with that. That means, OP minus OA. That is, OP minus OA. This all terms I have explained in your basics of three-dimensional geometry terms. If you don't watch those things, I can't do anything. Clear? If you watch those things, these terms are going to be very useful. So, please make sure that you have watched that video clearly and you took the notes one by one so that these terms are going to be very, very simple. So, these all terms I have explained in the previous class or the previous video. So, vector OA is position vector of A, vector OP is position vector of P, vector AP is vector OP minus vector OA. OA is represented as vector A, OP is represented as vector R, AP is represented as OP minus OA. Here I am solving the theorem. I am not representing anything. Here I am solving the theorem by drawing the particular diagram. Clear? Okay. So now these all terms are given in your theorem. Here what I have written? These all terms are given here. Vector AP is nothing but the line passing through the given point parallel to the given vector. Don't get confused. Vector AP is nothing but what? It is a line parallel to given vector B. Are you getting my point? So, vector AP is a line parallel to a given vector B. Okay, students? So, to solve this theorem, first thing, you must know how to represent your diagram. That means, how to draw the given terms. If you draw the given terms, half of the theorem is over. Are you getting my point? If you draw the statement, the half of theorem is done. You don't need to remember anything. The terms which the given in question paper has to be represented in the diagrammatical form in your answer sheet. That is important. Clear? So now you represent in answer sheet with the diagram. What you are drawing on the diagram, you write here. Are you getting my point? So if you want to write the explanation of this diagram, you just write in your own words that L be the line passing through the given point A parallel to the given vector B, where OA is the position vector, OP is the, where P is the arbitrary point, OP is the position vector of point P. You just write these terms in English form. That means vector OA is position vector of A, write it. OP is position vector of P, write. AP is given by vector OP minus vector OA, write it. Position vector of P minus position vector of A. If you write that, that is what the explanation of the diagram. Clear? So don't need to again I explain that. Clear? You just see the diagram and you write it. No problem. L be the line passing through the point A be the position vector, OA is A is the given point, OA is the position vector, B is arbitrary point, OP is OP is position vector of point P, and vector D is given vector. Write it by your own words, no problem. Clear? The very important things are this mathematical form. Clear? In whatever you write in your own words of the explanation of your diagram will be expected, accepted, no problem. Clear? But write in correct grammatical way, no problem. So now, see, to solve this theorem, now what we have did, we have written the terms which they have given in statement form, we have written in mathematical form. Now, what we need to solve this theorem? See, again I am telling, what we need to solve this theorem 1, that is line passing through a given point and parallel to a given vector. Please remember, my dear students, here only a single line, that means a single drop is very important. What is that single drop? I will write here and you make sure that you are going to remember that a single word unless and until you complete your exam. If you remember what I write here, if you remember that, you can write your complete theorem. Please remember that what I am writing here, if you write or if you remember that, you can write your complete theorem. Are you getting my point? So for that reason, see, here vector AP is the line passing through a given point, vector B is a given vector, that means these two are the two lines which are parallel. Are you getting my point? AP is one line, vector B is second line, both are parallel to each other because see here they have given parallel. Clear? Vector B is parallel to vector AP. So go to 11th standard, straight line chapter. Go to 11th standard, straight line chapter. There you have studied that if two lines are parallel, their direction ratios are equal. Are you getting my point? If two lines are parallel, their direction ratios are equal. Again, I am telling, make a note. If two lines are parallel, direction ratios are equal. That is, we know that. You must know that if two lines are parallel, direction ratios are equal. That is, see, here the line is vector AP and the second line is vector B. Their direction ratios are equal means the AP divided by vector B equal to lambda. Vector AP by vector B equal to lambda. This is nothing but if two lines are parallel, their direction ratios are equal. I am writing it in vector form. I am writing it in vector form. In Cartesian form, x by x1 equal to y by y1 equal to z by z1. You can write. But here we are representing in vector form. So we can write it as vector AP divided by vector B equal to lambda, because as you all know, if two lines are parallel, their direction ratios are equal. So if you simplify this, how it is going to be? If I multiply vector B here, it will be vector AP equal to lambda times of vector B. Okay students, see, this you must remember. Clear? How to remember? See, you must remember it with the theorem only. For example, for this theorem, equation of line passing through a given point parallel to the given vector is given by vector AP equal to lambda vector B. That part you have to remember. Are you getting my point? Because if you know this, further things are very very simple. Are you getting my point? This theorem has to be remembered. If this you forget, the complete theorem is gone. Are you getting my point? If you don't remember this, the complete theorem is gone. Clear? So for that reason, see how to remember this, the equation. While practicing, you must practice it as equation of line passing through given point parallel to given vector is written as vector AP equal to lambda times of vector b. Now the complete theorem is over. If you write the diagram at this things 50%, if you write this 100%, the further things are just the calculations, no problem. Clear? Because you know the formula of vector AP. What is vector AP formula? Vector AP is given by OP minus OA. Already you know OP is position vector of point P, OA is position vector of point A. That also you know, no problem. Clear? So for that reason, make sure that this will be perfect to you. So here, now simplify. This implies how you write vector AP. Vector AP is written as OP minus OA. Vector AP is written as OP minus OA. That is formula of vector AP equal to lambda times of vector B. Next, this implies OP equal to OA plus lambda times of vector B. These all calculations are very simple. Vector OP is what? R. Vector OA is what? A. Plus lambda times of vector B. So this is your vector form. This is your vector form. See how it is simple. If you know the basics, are getting my point? So you remember the theorem as the line passing through a given point and parallel to a given vector is written as what? Vector AP equal to lambda times of vector B. With the statement, you remember that. Clear? If you remember with the statement, by reading this statement directly, you can write this. But the diagram is needed. Clear? So by remembering with the statement, this thing, the calculations will be simple. AP equal to lambda times of B means AP is what? OP minus OA equal to lambda B. OP is what? R. OA is what? A. If you write that, vector form is over. Now we shall go for Cartesian form. Again, you must know the basics. Clear? A, given point, A is represented as what? X1, Y1, Z1. Given point in Cartesian form. See, Cartesian form. How to write the given point? Okay. How to write the given point in Cartesian form? Vector A is written as x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap in Cartesian form. That is vector A. See, vector B is a parallel vector. That is not a point. Vector B is parallel vector. That means here vector B is written as A I cap plus otherwise you can write as capital A I cap, capital B J cap, capital C K cap. No problem. You use either a small or capital, it doesn't matter, but no problem. For our clarifications, you write it as capital A B C because vector B is parallel vector. Anyways, in the previous class, that is in the basics, I have not represented vector, just I have represented vector AP. Clear? So, if B is given vector, make sure that vector B should be written as AI cap plus BJ cap plus C K cap. Clear? Again, how to write vector R? Vector R is written as XI cap plus YJ cap plus Z K cap. See, my dear students, this is your vector form. After solving the theorem in vector form, the terms in the vector form has to be written in Cartesian form. Please remember, the terms in the vector form has to be written in the Cartesian form. Clear? Okay. So now, using all these terms in, you write it as equation 1, that is nothing but in vector form. That means this all terms has to be used here. Clear? So that means, see, vector r equal to vector a plus lambda times of vector b. If I take vector a on this side, no problem. Clear? Either wise, you take this as equation 1, no problem. The calculations will be simple. You take this as equation 1. Using all these terms in equation 1. Clear? What is OP minus OA? OP you have, that is vector r. Vector r is nothing but vector OP. Vector b is nothing but vector OB. So that is vector b. This is nothing but vector OA. Clear? Vector b is vector b because it is parallel vector. Vector r is vector OP. Vector a is vector OA. These all terms you must know. Okay. So now, by knowing all these terms, use these terms in equation 1. What we are going to have in equation 1? That is OP minus OA. You have to calculate OP minus OA. That means vector R minus vector A. Vector R, A if you take this answer, it will be vector R minus vector A. Vector OP minus vector A means R minus A. That is X minus X1 I cap. X minus X1 I cap. Next, plus Y minus Y1 J cap. Y minus Y1 J cap. Next, plus Z minus Z1 K cap is equal to what? Lambda B. Is equal to lambda B is written as what? A I cap plus B J cap plus C K cap. Clear? See, OP minus OA, that means vector R minus vector A. OP minus OA, so X minus X1 I cap plus Y minus Y1 J cap plus Z minus Z1 K cap. Clear, students? So that will be equal to, see, that will be equal to what? Lambda times of vector B. That will be equal to lambda times of vector B means lambda equal to B is A I cap plus B J cap plus C K cap. Just directly write it. No problem. Clear? So using the equation 1, all the steps in using in equation 1, OP minus OA equal to lambda times of B, you are going to get this equation. Further, if two vectors are equal, see, LHS is equal to RHS. Here, LHS is equal to RHS. Left hand side is equal to right hand side. On both sides, you have two vectors. One is x minus x1 I cap plus y minus y1 j cap plus z minus z1 k cap equal to lambda times of a I cap plus b j cap plus c k cap. Clear? So here what you have two vectors. As you all know, two vectors are equal if and only if their direction and their magnitude is same. Clear? Two vectors are equal if and only if their magnitude and their direction is same. So here these two vectors are equal. So if I simplify this the component wise, I can write it as, see, how can I write? Further, I can write it as this equation. I am going to write component wise x minus x1 equal to x minus x1 equal to lambda a. Next, y minus y1 equal to lambda b. Z minus z1 equal to lambda c. Because if two vectors are equal, the direction and the components must be equal. So here I am writing the components. Direction already known. So components are equal. Therefore, this can be written as x minus x1 by a equal to lambda, y minus y1 by b equal to lambda, z minus z1 by c equal to lambda. Therefore, your answer will be x minus x1 by a
equal to y minus y1 by b equal to z minus z1 by c. So this is your final solution, that is Cartesian form. This is Cartesian form and this is vector form. Cartesian form and vector form. So students, as I said, if you know this, you can simplify the further things. If you don't know this, you can't do anything. Are you getting my point? So like this, there are 6 to 7 I have written in box. For each theorem, there is one box. Clear? For each theorem, there is one statement of this kind. If you remember those 6 statements, directly you can remember all 6 statements, 6 theorems. See how to remember this. If you remember this, AP will be written as OP minus OA, that is common sense. OP minus OA equal to lambda times of B. OP, if I take minus OA on that side, it will be OA plus lambda times of B. OP is R, OA is A. Written further things. Clear? This is vector form. Clear? Now, by using this vector form, write in Cartesian form. Just you must know the basics. R is written as xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap because this is arbitrary. A is written as x1i cap plus y1j cap plus z1k cap. Vector B is written as ai cap plus bj cap plus ck cap. That's all. If you write these all terms in Cartesian form and you use these terms in equation 1. See, where is equation 1? This. You use in this equation 1. OP minus OA. What is OP minus OA? This is OP, this is OA. OP minus OA means x minus x1 I cap plus y minus y1 j cap plus z minus z1 k cap over that you have written here equal to what is here b lambda times of a I cap plus b j cap plus c k cap. Just you go on replacing these terms in Cartesian form. Just you go on replacing these terms in Cartesian form so that your terms are going to be easy. That means you must know the just representations. X minus x1 equal to what? Lambda a. Y minus y1 will be equal to what? Lambda b. Z minus z1 will be equal to what? Lambda c. Further you simplify this. Simplify, simplify. Therefore all terms are equal to lambda. This is equal to lambda. Second term equal to lambda. Third term equal to lambda. Therefore all three terms are equal. Then we can write it as x minus x1 by a equal to y minus y1 by b equal to z minus z1 by c. So this is your theorem 1. Clear, students? So I think all the terms are very clear to you. So if you get any doubts, you can ask as usual. Clear? So you can ask any doubts from these terms. If no problem, no worries. If you have any doubts, please ask. Okay, students. So previously here some terms were missing in the video, but now no problem. See, all the terms are visible here now. So you take that x minus x1 I cap plus y minus y1 j cap plus z minus z1 k cap equal to lambda, all the terms. So now it's there visible in your video. So you just note this theorem. Clear? First, note the statement by pausing the video. After that, I said what to remember. You write it the side by the theorem. We should remember that, like that you write. And I have repeated what you have to remember. So pause that video while writing the remembering words. So after that, see this. Go on simplifying. Now all the terms are visible. This is already visible. No problem. So take the notes by pausing video. Hi students. Okay. So now we have seen our theorem number 1 of 3-dimensional geometry. In that we have proved that the line passing through one point and parallel to given vector. That means we have given the equation of line passing through one point and parallel to given vector in space. So we have used the equation of parallel lines and we have solved the theorem number 1. So now we shall go for theorem number 2. Clear? So for this theorem number 2, what we have to derive, let us see. What they are asking, derive the equation of line passing through two given points both in vector form and Cartesian form. So theorem 1 was line passing through one point. Theorem 2 is line passing through two points. Are you getting my terms clear? Okay. First theorem was line passing through one point and parallel to given vector. There you have to remember vector AP equal to lambda times of vector B for the theorem 1. Okay. So now to derive the theorem number 2, that is line passing through two points, what we have to do, let us see. Okay. See the proof. Here, while solving the proof of theorems, the diagram is very important. If the diagram is wrong, then you can lose 1 to 2 marks. Clear? So that's why be very careful while drawing the diagrams of three-dimensional geometry. In this theorem, what they are telling, line is, take this line passing through point A and this is point B, join O to A, join O to B, clear? So now OA is position vector of point A, OB is position vector of point B, and take one arbitrary point P and join O to P. Clear, students? So here A and B are two given terms. A and B are two given points. P is arbitrary point. OA is position vector of point A. OA is position vector of point A. I will write it as vector A. Position vector of point A is taken as vector A. Next, OB is taken as vector B. Position vector of point B is taken as vector B. And next, OP vector, position vector of arbitrary point, where P is arbitrary point, I will take it as vector OP equal to vector R. Clear? So now you have drawn the diagram of line passing through two points A and B. You have chosen one arbitrary point P. Clear? So now we shall solve this theorem. Now you have written what the terms are given here. Clear? What the terms are given in theorem, that you have written here. Using these terms, you have to prove the theorem. Clear? So for that, please remember in the first theorem, you should remember one term, that is vector AB equal to, sorry, vector AB equal to lambda times of vector B. This was the statement that you should remember for the theorem number 1, that is vector AP equal to lambda times of vector B. But here there is a slight change. See, this was the point which you have to remember for the theorem number 1, that is line passing through one point and parallel to a given vector. Clear? So for this, in the second theorem, there is a slight change. In the place of B, we should write it as vector AB. Clear, students? So this you must remember for theorem number 2. Clear? For the theorem number 1, here there was small vector B. Now you have to write capital AB vector. Clear? If you remember this, you can solve the complete theorem as you have solved in your first theorem. Clear? On the same way, here you have to go on solving the theorem. Clear? How can you write AP vector? You can write it as vector OP minus vector OA. Vector AP can be written as vector OP minus vector A. Next, lambda times of AB vector can be written as vector OB minus vector OA. Clear? Vector AB is written as vector OB minus vector OA. AP is written as OP minus OA. Clear? Now, OP is what? Vector R. OA is what? Vector A. Equal to lambda times of OB vector is what? Vector B. Minus OA vector is what? Vector A. So, you write all the terms as here. So now, how can you write these terms? That is, vector R equal to vector A plus lambda times of vector B minus vector A. Clear, students? So this is your vector form. Clear? This is your vector form, where OP is R, OA is A, OB is B. Clear? Vector R is position vector of point P, vector A is position vector of point A, vector B is position vector of point B. So using all those terms, you should write here. That is, vector R equal to vector A plus lambda times of vector B minus vector A. So that will be your vector form. Dear students, as you all studied in the first theorem, after coming to the vector form, using this vector form, you have to write all the terms of vector form in Cartesian form. So for that, we shall write all the terms in Cartesian form. Clear? Okay. So here, we shall write all the terms in Cartesian form. Okay. See, vector R should be written in Cartesian form, vector A should be written in Cartesian form, vector B should be written in Cartesian form. In Cartesian form, what is vector R? Vector R equal to xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. Next, what is vector A in Cartesian form? What is vector A? Vector A is x1i cap plus y1j cap plus z1k cap. Clear? Because here A is position vector of point A. A is position vector of point A. In this point A is given. Here A can be written as vector OA also. Clear? Next, what is vector B? Vector B equal to x2i cap plus y2j cap plus z2k cap. So this is equal to vector OB. Clear, students? So these all terms we are writing it in Cartesian form. Clear? We are writing all the terms in Cartesian form. So while writing Cartesian form, take R as xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap, because R means position vector of point P, where point P is what? Arbitrary point. You take point A, that is your given point A, that is written as vector A. Vector B is the position vector of point B. So by using all these terms in equation 1, see, you take this as equation 1, or you can take this as equation 1. So for this, we shall take this as equation 1. Clear? So this is vector form. So now in equation 1, what we have? OP minus OA. OP means what? Your vector R. This is vector OP. Clear? OP minus OA. Using equation 1, what is OP minus OA? OP is R, OA is A. OP minus OA means it will be x minus x1 I cap. Clear? Next, y minus y1 j cap, plus z minus z1 k cap. Clear, students? So using your equation 1, OP minus OA, you have to solve. OP means vector R, OA means vector A. So vector r minus vector a, x minus x1 I cap plus y minus y1 j cap plus z minus z1 k cap you got for LHS. Now let us look at RHS. See, what is RHS? Lambda times of OB minus OA. So you write lambda as it is, lambda as it is OB minus OA. That means OB minus OA, vector B minus vector A. So therefore x2 minus x1 I cap plus y2 minus y1 j cap plus z2 minus z1 k cap. Clear, student? So using your equation 1, your theorem will be x minus x1 I cap plus y minus y1 j cap plus z minus z1 k cap equal to lambda times of OB minus OA. OB minus OA, x2 minus x1 I cap plus y2 minus y1 j cap plus z2 minus z1 k cap will be your solution of equation 1 in Cartesian form. Clear? Okay. So now, taking LHS equal to RHS, LHS equal to RHS, we can write this as, see, LHS equal to RHS. If two vectors has to be equal, that means in LHS you have one vector, in RHS you have another vector. Here LHS must be equal to RHS means you have to make two vectors are equal. We know that two vectors are equal if and only if their magnitude and their direction is same. So the magnitude of I is what? The magnitude of I is here x minus x1 must be equal to what? Lambda times of x2 minus x1. Clear? Next, y minus y1 must be equal to what? Y minus y1, y minus y1 must be equal to lambda times of y2 minus y1. Are you getting my point? So x minus x1 must be equal to lambda times of x2 minus x1, y minus y1 must be equal to lambda times of y2 minus y1. On the same way, z minus, on the same way, z minus, okay, I'll write here, on the same way, z minus z1 must be equal to lambda times of z minus z1 must be equal to lambda times of z2 minus z1. Clear? See, from this we can say that x minus x1 equal to lambda times of x2 minus x1, y minus y1 must be equal to lambda times of y2 minus y1, z minus z1 must be equal to lambda times of z2 minus z1. So solving these things, what you are going to have? You are going to have x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1 equal to lambda. On the same way, y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1 equal to lambda. On the same way, if you simplify this, z minus z1 divided by z2 minus z1 equal to lambda. Clear? So by solving these things, see, you have x minus x1 equal to lambda times of x2 minus x1. Here y minus y1 equal to lambda times of y2 minus y1. Here z minus z1 equal to lambda times of z2 minus z1. Because if the vectors has to be equal, the components of I, j and k must be equal. So therefore you will get this term. If I simplify this, you are going to have x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1 must be equal to y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1 must be equal to z minus z1 divided by z2 minus z1. So this is the proof of Cartesian form. This is the proof of vector form. Clear? So this is your Cartesian form. Clear? Okay. So If you want to solve this theorem, first you remember vector AP equal to lambda times of vector AB is very essential point, because this complete theorem depends on this small statement. If you remember this, you can go on solving each and every step very easily, because AP you know OP minus OA, AB you know OB minus OA. Already you have taken OB, OA, OP, right? All those terms, just a small simplification. After coming to vector form, using your vector form, write all the terms in Cartesian form. After writing in Cartesian form, use equation 1. So take this equation 1, OP minus OA, OB minus OA. You write that OP minus OA means R minus A. OB minus OA means B minus A. So you are going to have X minus X1, Y minus Y1, Z minus Z1. Here you are going to have X2 minus X1, Y2 minus Y1, Z2 minus Z1. You will get this equation LHS is equal to RHS. So LHS must be equal to RHS if and only if the components are equal. That means magnitudes of the components are equal. This is I component, this is J component, this is K component. Clear? So their magnitudes are equal. If you simplify that, X minus X1 divided by X2 minus X1 equal to lambda, Y minus Y1 divided by Y2 minus Y1 equal to lambda, Z minus Z1 divided by Z2 minus Z1 equal to lambda. So these are the three terms. So if these three terms are same, that is equal to lambda, then this implies, so your final solution. Clear, students? So this is what your second theorem. So for the second theorem, this is very important. Clear? If this is remembering for you, then this term is going to be very simple. So please make sure that diagram will be correct whenever you are solving theorem number 2. So theorem 1 was line passing through 1 point. Theorem 2 is line passing through 2 points. For theorem 1, vector AP equal to lambda times of vector B. Theorem 2, vector AP equal to lambda times of vector AB. Clear? Okay, students. Now let us go for your third theorem, that is derive the equation of plane in normal form both in vector and Cartesian. Clear? So till now we have solved lines in space. Till now we have solved line in space passing through one point and passing through two points. So now we are solving the theorem on plane. Clear? So first let us draw the theorem which the terms are given. What are the terms given here? Normal form. That means derive the equation of plane in normal form. That means normal vector will be given to you. Clear? Normal vector will be given to you. Using that normal vector, you have to find this theorem. Clear? Okay. So first, let us draw x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, x, y and z. Clear? Okay. So by using this, let us take one plane on your x, y and z axis. X, y and z axis. This will be the plane. And let us draw the normal. So this will be the normal to the plane. Normal to the plane means the perpendicular vector drawn to the plane from the origin will call normal of the plane. Clear? Perpendicular vector drawn for the plane from the origin will be called as normal vector or normal to the plane. Now I will take one arbitrary point P, because this is ON vector which is perpendicular to the plane. I will take arbitrary point P and I will join O to P. This will be the OP vector, position vector of point P. Now I will join N P. Clear? From the diagram, here we can see that NP vector is perpendicular to ON vector. NP vector is perpendicular to ON vector. So using that, let us simplify this theorem. No problem. But you must remember, normal vector ON will be taken as D dot N cap. Will be taken as D dot N cap. Clear? So D dot N cap means D will be the magnitude of ON. N cap will be the unit vector of ON. Because whenever you are finding the vector, the formula says that unit vector multiplied with the magnitude will give you the required vector. Because here the required vector is ON. So if I multiply unit vector with the magnitude of that ON will give me that vector ON. Clear? So using that ON, that is normal vector to the plane, now let us find our equation. Clear? Okay. Here what is OP vector? OP vector is vector R. That is position vector of point P. Okay. So from diagram, from the diagram we can see that vector NP is perpendicular to vector ON. Vector NP is perpendicular to vector ON. Vector NP is perpendicular to vector ON. See, vector ON and vector NP are perpendicular to each other. So if two lines are perpendicular to each other, we know that their dot product must be zero. That means vector NP dot vector ON must be equal to zero. Either you write it here. This implies vector NP dot vector ON is equal to zero. Clear? That means if two vectors are perpendicular to each other, their dot product is zero. As you used in your straight line chapter that if two lines are perpendicular to each other, the sum of product of the direction ratios are equal to zero. On the same way, here the dot product of the two vectors is also equal to zero. Same, everything is same, but it is in vector form. That's it. Clear? So now, what is NP? NP is OP minus ON. What is ON? First, let us write ON as it is, equal to 0. Clear? Now, what is OP? Here, OP is vector R minus. What is ON? ON is D dot N cap. Again, ON is D dot N cap. Must be equal to 0. Okay, students. So now you are going to get vector R minus D dot N cap into D dot N cap is equal to 0. See here what happens. If this term must be equal to 0, this term must be equal to 0. Here, what is D? D is magnitude. That means length. That is, D must be not equal to 0. As usual, we know that D is length. Length will be not equal to 0. So, for that reason, what we do? We take it as vector R minus vector D dot N cap dot N cap is equal to 0. As you all know, while solving this equation, this is the product of two terms. In this product of two terms, D cannot be 0. This is first term. This is second term. D cannot be 0. Therefore, D is not equal to 0. What will be remaining thing? R minus D dot N cap equal to 0. So, now multiply the terms. What you are going to have? Vector R dot N cap minus D dot N cap will be equal to 0. Clear? So now, because N cap dot N cap is unit vector, again it will be N cap, no problem. So that is R dot N cap minus D dot N cap will be equal to 0. Therefore, vector r dot n cap will be equal to d, because here n cap is unit vector, so n cap dot d will be only d. Clear? So vector r dot n cap equal to d. Clear, students? So please remember that here n cap is unit vector, n cap is unit vector. If you don't remember the things, you slightly write here, that is n cap dot n cap equal to 1. Right? N cap dot n cap equal to 1, because n cap is unit vector, again n cap is unit vector. As you all know, I cap dot I cap is 1, j cap dot j cap is 1, k cap dot k cap is 1. On the same way, product of two unit vectors will be equal to 1. Here this will be, okay, d cap, n cap dot n cap will be 1, n cap dot n cap will be 1. Therefore, from this we can say that r dot n cap equal to d. So this is your vector form. This is your vector form. Take it as equation 1. Clear, students? So here ends your vector form. Clear? What is vector form? R dot n cap equal to d, because n cap dot n cap is 1. So here n cap dot r will be r dot n cap, n cap dot n cap will be 1. Therefore r dot n cap minus d dot 1 will be equal to 0. Therefore n cap dot n cap is 1. Okay. So now let us go for Cartesian form. In Cartesian form, see, r is written as xi cap plus yj cap plus z k cap, and n cap is written as li cap plus mj cap plus n k cap, because here n cap is normal vector, l and m and n are going to be the direction ratios of your normal vector. So n cap is written as li cap plus mj cap plus n k cap. As you all know, r is the position vector. It will be written as xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap from equation 1. From equation 1, that is r dot n cap, that is xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap dot with what? Li cap plus mj cap plus nk cap equal to d. That is magnitude. Clear? In the place of r, you write this. In the place of n, you write this. Clear? So now, if you make dot product of these two, your theorem will be Lx plus my, my plus nz equal to 0. So, this will be the proof of your Cartesian form. This is Cartesian form. Clear, friends? Okay. So in Cartesian form, you write r as xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. You write n cap as li cap plus mj cap plus nk cap. So by using these two in your equation 1, you are going to have dot product of these two. I cap dot I cap is 1, j cap dot j cap is 1, k cap dot k cap is 1. So it will be lx plus my plus nz equal to d. This is equal to d. Clear, students? So therefore lx plus my plus nz equal to d, because in the LHS you have d, so it will be equal to d. Clear? Okay, this is what your theorem number 3. So in theorem number 3, this thing is very, very important, as well as ON you must remember. If you remember this, you can write NP as OP minus ON, ON as D dot N cap. You replace those terms. Here D is not equal to 0, so for that reason we get R minus D dot N cap equal to 0. Again, r dot n cap, it will be remain same as it is. n cap dot n cap is 1 because this is unit vector. So you take minus d on that side. So therefore, r dot n cap will be equal to d using Cartesian form. So very simple theorem, but you must be very careful while solving the diagram and while simplifying. Here you remember n cap dot n cap is 1 because we know that dot product of i cap is 1, j cap is 1, k cap dot k cap is 1. So for that reason you should remember those terms. If you multiply these two, you will get your Cartesian form. Clear, students? Okay, fourth theorem. Clear? The fourth theorem is derive the equation of plane passing through given point. That means your plane is passing through the given point and perpendicular to given vector. So here two terms are given. One is point passing through the plane and another one is perpendicular vector to the plane. Clear? So for that, let us construct the diagram. X-axis, y-axis, z-axis. So let us take the plane passing through a point A. Let us take a plane passing through a point A, and this is perpendicular vector n. This is the perpendicular vector n to the plane. Clear, students? So this is the plane x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. Perpendicular vector to the plane is given, point A is given, and plane is passing through the point A and perpendicular to given vector. Now if I join O to A, it will be position vector of point A. Take one point P, that is arbitrary point here. Take one arbitrary point P and join O to P. So here OA is position vector of point A, that is vector A. OP is position vector of point P, that is vector R. Clear? So now I will join AP. So if I join AP vector, see, AP vector is on plane. Plane is perpendicular to N. That means for this plane, see here, for this plane it is perpendicular. That means this should be perpendicular to your AP also, because AP vector is on the plane. AP vector is on the plane. See, if this is plane, AP vector is on the plane and here it is perpendicular, means it should be perpendicular to AP also. So that from diagram we can say that from diagram we can say that AP vector is perpendicular to vector N. AP vector is perpendicular to vector N. Again, both the vectors are perpendicular, means it implies AP dot vector N must be equal to 0. Again, this you must remember. Clear, students? In the third theorem, AP dot ON was equal to 0. Are you getting my point? In the third theorem, in the place of N, you have ON, that is normal vector. Clear? But here they have not mentioned this is normal vector, just they have mentioned any perpendicular vector. So for that any perpendicular vector, we have taken only vector N. That is what the small difference, that's all. You leaving that, there is no any other difference. Clear, students? So vector N dot vector AP equal to 0. So how can you write AP? OP minus OA dot n cap, sorry, n vector equal to 0. OP is r minus a dot vector n equal to 0. So this is vector form. Clear? So call it as equation 1. This is vector form r minus a dot n equal to 0 because AB is perpendicular to n, because AB is on plane. For that plane, n is perpendicular, therefore it should be perpendicular to AB also. Clear? So therefore AP is OP minus OA dot n equal to 0. OP is R, OA is A dot n equal to 0. Here OP is position vector of point P, OA is position vector of point A, n is perpendicular vector to the plane. So now in Cartesian form, that is in Cartesian form, Cartesian form, see, this must be written in Cartesian form. R, how you write? Xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. Clear? A, given point, how you write? Vector A equal to x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap. Clear? N should be written in Cartesian form, that is vector n equal to capital A I cap plus B j cap plus C k cap. You use all these three terms in vector, all these three terms in equation 1. R minus A, that means using equation 1, using equation 1, R minus A, R minus A, it will be x minus x1 I cap plus again y minus y1 j cap plus z minus z1 k cap. This is dot product with, this term is dot product with n, that is A I cap plus B j cap plus C k cap, and it is equal to 0. Clear? So this term is dot with A I cap plus B j cap plus C k cap equal to 0. If I make these two as dot products, clear? If I make those two terms as dot product, see here, I cap will be 1, A into x minus x1. So it will be, what you are going to have, A into x minus x1 plus B into y minus y1 plus C into z minus z1 equal to 0. So this is your Cartesian form. Clear? This is your Cartesian form of this particular theorem. This is vector form, equation 1, and this is Cartesian form. So to solve Cartesian form, you must remember AP dot n equal to 0. If you want to complete this theorem, you should remember this AP dot n equal to 0. See, if you know what should be remembered for the first theorem, you can easily solve second theorem. If you know what you can solve for the third theorem, you can easily solve the fourth theorem. That is, if you know for first theorem, what you have to remember, vector AP equal to lambda times of B. For the second theorem, you should remember vector AP equal to lambda times of AB. For the third theorem, you should remember vector AP dot vector ON equal to 0. For the fourth theorem, you must remember AP dot n equal to 0. So if you remember this all four statements, then you can solve all four theorems very very easily. Clear? So you remember those things. AP dot n equal to 0, AP is OP minus OA dot n equal to 0, OP is R, OA is A, n as it is. This is equation 1 in vector form. In Cartesian form, you must write all these terms in Cartesian form, that is R, A and N. R is xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. A is x1 I cap, y1 j cap, z1 k cap, n is capital A cap, capital B j cap, capital C k cap. So you use all this in equation 1, r minus a dot n. This is r minus a dot n. If I make dot product, A into x minus x1 plus B into y minus y1 plus C into z minus z1 will be equal to 0, because I cap dot I cap is 1, j cap dot j cap is 1, k cap dot k cap is 1. So for that reason, this is your Cartesian form of plane passing through given point and perpendicular to given vector. So these are your 4 important theorems. So remaining theorems I will do in next class. Clear?